Here at Firebase, we're on a never-ending quest to make it easier for you to build successful apps. And since we've expanded Firebase to a fully featured app development platform, we've been working hard to build the improvements and enhancements you've been asking for. For instance, we recently added StreamView, which lets you view samples of your analytics data in real time, so you can see how users all around the world are interacting with your app at that very moment. We also added support for DebugView, which lets you view every analytics event recorded and sent by a test device to make sure you've implemented your analytics exactly the way you'd like. Ooh, looks like you forgot a semicolon there. We launched Cloud Functions for Firebase, which gives you the ability to run server-side logic without ever needing your own servers. You can use Cloud Functions to do everything from sending out notifications to users in a chat app, to performing server-side image processing, to running sensitive business logic that you just don't trust your client with. We've also launched support for a number of Firebase products on both Unity and C++ for all you cross-platform game developers out there. And this year at I/O, we announced a whole new set of features to make it even easier for you to build successful apps. We're adding phone number authentication to Firebase Auth, so you can sign in your users with a simple text message. Because it turns out, nobody is really all that excited about the idea of creating yet another password. We've also added Firebase Performance Monitoring, because we know your fast and responsive app might not be so fast and responsive when your users aren't on the same awesome Wi-Fi connection as your office. Now you can find out when your apps are running slowly or just taking too darn long to get you the data that you need based on performance data from actual users in the real world. And while Firebase Hosting has always been a great place for you to serve fast and secure static content for your web app, we've now added support for you to perform server-side processing through Cloud Functions. This means you can now serve dynamic content in your Firebase Hosting website, all without needing to set up or manage your own servers. In Google Analytics for Firebase, the product formerly known as Firebase Analytics, we've added reporting for custom event parameters. So you can now view summaries of up to 50 parameters that you're passing along to Analytics, whether that's the final score in your game or how long it took your user to complete the tutorial, right there in the Firebase console. And if that isn't enough, you can always export your raw analytics data to BigQuery, Google's super powerful data warehouse in the cloud, to perform more sophisticated analysis. And we're happy to announce that we've added a new free tier that lets you store analytics data. Combine that with our recently added 1 terabyte of free query data, and there's a lot you can do in BigQuery for a very little amount of money. We've also enhanced our analytics data with event data from AdMob, Google's in-app advertising solution. Now you can automatically view reports for ad impressions, exposure time, and clicks for all ads served through AdMob. This also gives you a more accurate view of your user's lifetime value and ARPU, because these reports are based not just on the in-app purchases your users make, but also on how much advertising revenue they've earned for you. So you get a much better understanding of where you are and aren't making money in your app. We've added Firebase Test Lab support for games, because it turns out that automated testing is something game developers want just as much as the rest of us. Finally, we started open sourcing many of our SDKs to help empower all of you and the developer community to build out Firebase the way you want. And then we decided that's basically everything you need to develop the perfect app, and we've stopped working on anything new. No, just kidding. We're constantly working on all sorts of new features for you, and we'll have a lot more news to announce over the next several months. So make sure you subscribe to the Firebase channel, and maybe check out our blog post from time to time to see what's new. But until then, it's never been a better time to start developing your app with Firebase. Why not give it a try today? You can check out our fancy new website to see what Firebase can do for you, and then start using Firebase in your own app. We can't wait to see what you build.